Hello everyone. We know that the Bible is divided into two parts, the Old Testament and the New Testament. The New Testament contains hundreds of quotations and references to the Old Testament. Some of them are prophecies or predictions about the Messiah which were fulfilled by Jesus Christ. The first prophecy foretold by the prophet Isaiah was fulfilled when Jesus was conceived in the womb of his mother Mary through the Holy Spirit. The second prophecy, predicted by the prophet Micah, was fulfilled when Jesus was born in Bethlehem. This happened because Mary and Joseph, following the requirement of their day, had gone to Bethlehem to register themselves for the census. The third prophecy, foreseen by the prophet Hosea, was fulfilled when Joseph and Mary took Jesus to Egypt. Hosea said, "When Israel was a child, I loved him, and I called my son out of Egypt." The fourth prophecy, which we read in today's Gospel, was fulfilled when Jesus left Nazareth and went to live in Capernaum. Friends, Isaiah, 700 years before the time of Jesus, prophesied, "First the Lord degraded the land of Zebulun and the land of Naphtali. But in the end he glorified the seaward road, the land west of the Jordan, the district of the Gentiles. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Upon those who dwelt in the land of gloom, a light has shone." Friends, Matthew believed that this prophecy was fulfilled when Jesus, after the arrest of John the Baptist, went from his hometown Nazareth to live in Capernaum in the region of Zebulun and Naphtali. Let us briefly take a look at Jewish history so we can understand this prophecy better. In the Bible, Jacob, the son of Isaac, is called Israel, meaning one that struggled with a divine angel or one who has prevailed with God. Jacob had 12 sons who became the fathers of the 12 tribes of Israel. Naphtali and Zebulun were the 6th and the 10th son of Jacob respectively. Each tribe lived in a certain area. So the land of Zebulun and the land of Naphtali referred to the land where these two tribes lived. By the time of Jesus, the land had been conquered many times and was then under the Roman Empire. They were on the north and west of the Sea of Galilee and the River Jordan, and were predominantly occupied by Gentiles, and it was not part of Jewish Israel any longer. It was a land that once had belonged to the chosen people of God, but now occupied by the Gentiles, meaning non-Jews or foreigners. This is the land of Zebulun and the land of Naphtali, the way to the sea beyond the Jordan, the Galilee of the Gentiles, that Jesus visited almost immediately after the arrest of John the Baptist to bring light to the people who sit in darkness and dwell in a land overshadowed by death. Friends, in the Bible, "sit in darkness" refers to the lack of knowledge of God or the ignorance of God's word. In other words, these two tribes lived not necessarily in sin, but in godlessness. They lived without God. They were separated from their God. Isaiah further described the sitting in darkness to a life living in the shadow of death. That is to say, lacking the knowledge of God or not knowing God or being separated from God is equal to being dead. To them Jesus preached, "Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand." Friends, repentance not merely involves contrition or an apology, but a change in direction, a change in behavior, and a change in one's life. We see the extent of change that took place in the fishermen who became Jesus' disciples. After Jesus had appeared in their life, those fishermen radically and dramatically changed their direction. Matthew writes that as Jesus was walking by the sea, he saw some fishermen hard at work, and he called them to follow him. and they abandoned their boats and commitments and followed Jesus. From that time on, Jesus went about preaching, teaching, and healing in the whole region, which was exactly what Isaiah the prophet had prophesied. Friends, what can we learn from this gospel passage? 1. We do not need to know all the biblical prophecies in chronological order, but it is crucial to understand and appreciate the prophecies, particularly the prophecies about Jesus and their fulfillment. Because Christianity is neither rooted in fear and superstitions, nor based on fairy tales or legends or mythology, but on the special revelation of the one true God, who made himself known through leaders, priests, and prophets many times in the past, and finally, fully and decisively, revealed the truth about himself in Jesus Christ. All the prophecies did not come about because of human will, but because of God's plan. From the beginning, therefore, God has carefully planned and prepared the salvation of the whole human race and seeks all peoples, both believers and non-believers. 2. Zebulun and Naphtali are good reminders for us Christians. Through baptism, we have become God's chosen people. However, we live in the Gentile world dominated by evil forces. Like the people of Israel, we constantly turn away from God. We lack the knowledge of God. We live without God. We live in darkness and in fear of death. Today, let us therefore heed Jesus' call to repentance. Let us turn our hearts and souls to Jesus Christ, so we too may be transformed by the love and light of Christ. Amen. God bless you.